Y'all ready for this?
Hey everybody, Coach Glad. I want to talk about defense. Often you see at any coaching level, more importantly at the youth level, defense is not really emphasized, it's not really coached at a fundamental, detailed way. And so I want to talk about defense in that regard, and especially what we look for in any defensive player and how it makes them to become a great defensive player. First thing is this right here. When we play the game of basketball, 80% plus, you are not touching this, okay? So what that means is defense is, if not way more important than the ball skills that is often seen and taught on the internet with professional coaches, trainers, you name it. A lot of times they're working on ball handling and shooting and techniques in regard to how to break down a defensive player, or how to do all the different skills, because we all think that this is the most important thing. In fact, I would also argue that defense is one of the most important things, because on offense, you could have one or two great players that the ball revolves around them, the offense revolves around them, where you're just one part of that offense. And you can actually, quite honestly, in some situations, you can take the play off. You know, for example, if you got one great player, he's got a hot hand, you know, he's doing all the action. He's going to the hoop and he's finishing. He's making plays happen. He's a playmaker, you name it, where you're just one person that's drawing defense on you. However, on defense is the one area you can never take a play off. You can never take a play off on defense. And so what I'm here to talk to you about is some of those core critical aspects of how to become a great defender. The first thing on being a great defensive player is, number one, is you have to make the decision to be a great player, a great defensive player. You gotta decide, and then you gotta commit to it. And then you gotta do the actions to make yourself a great defensive player. One of the key ingredients to be a great on-ball defender is looking at your offensive player. What is his tendencies? Is he a righty? Is he a lefty? Okay. If he's a right-handed player, more than likely you're gonna play him to the left. You're gonna force him to the left, because if he's a right-handed player, what you don't wanna do is play a guy neutral, because you put yourself at a chance of getting beat. So you either overplay them to the left, or you overplay them to the right, depending on are they a righty or a lefty. So that's one way to kind of give yourself an advantage. And in that regard, as a great defensive player, you always want to dictate the offense. You want to make them uncomfortable. You want to put them in situations that cause them anxiety, that cause them to make mistakes, okay? So what you want to do as a great defensive player is you always want to dictate. You don't want to react. And a great defensive player, he's forcing the offensive player out of his comfort zone. He's forcing the offensive player to make poor choices. So that's a great mindset to have, is always be a dictator on defense, not a reactive player. And so let's say, for example, I'm gonna force the person left. I'm gonna overplay their right foot. I'm gonna have a hand in the ball zone, or any place where the ball is, your hand is mirroring the ball. And the other hand is down low playing the crossover, or chumming, what they call chumming, or you're just getting some action. So what we wanna do is, there again, create chaos in the offensive player. And so what we want is a good wide base, not overly wide. You wanna be a good, you know, wider than a little athletic position, okay? You wanna be, another rule of thumb is be below the offensive player's head. So if the offensive player is up here, okay, you wanna be below their head. A good way to measure is your eyes are on his chin, but you always wanna watch his midsection. You don't wanna get caught watching the ball, okay? That, just use your hand to do that, okay? Use your peripheral vision, okay? And so what you're going to do is you're gonna overplay them, okay? You have a hand mirroring the ball, okay? We're closing the windows, okay? Making it hard for them to make a pass, but we're watching their midsection, okay? We're focused there, okay? Even if your hands make a deflection, that can cause a team turnover because we steal it, a team steal, okay? So it's not about just you stealing the ball or stealing the ball individually. You can cause a deflection and your teammates can pick up that steal. Okay, so there again, we're gonna overplay a little bit. All right, we're gonna be close to touch. That's the good distance to be away from your offensive player. Close enough to touch, okay? But we don't have our hands on them the whole time. You can poke on them, touch them a little bit, and just constantly mirroring them, mirroring the ball, all right? Watching their midsection. Don't get caught watching their eyes. Great offensive players, they can look off and make a pass away because they can see the court, okay? They can see an open player. So always just watch their midsection and be disciplined. Don't over jump, okay? All right, try to be disciplined. And so those are some of the rules and things you wanna look for in a great defensive player. They watch their midsection, okay? They dictate, they don't react to the offensive player, okay? So that right there are some key ingredients to be successful in defense. The other thing that I wanna point out is if the guy that you're guarding does not have the ball, you should always have your eyes on the ball and the eyes on your man. So you're like this, all right? And you should have your hands up, playing, okay? You might be in the help side or whatever, but you always wanna play the passing lanes. So you have a ball, your eyes on your man, and your eyes on the ball. You're always tracking the ball, okay? You're always watching your man, okay? And so there's an acronym that has commonly been put out there among basketball coaches. It's a really good one. And it really makes a lot of sense. To be a great defensive player, you wanna be a pest, okay? And a pest, like a bug, you're just, you know, mosquitoes, whatever. You just don't like pests being around you, right? And so what we want out of all of our basketball players is to be a pest. And P-E-S-T, let me go through that. P is you wanna be smart. You wanna play smart. Smart meaning you're not gonna get caught jumping and fake getting caught on a jump fake or a jump shot, you know, pump fake. You want to stay shot fake disciplined, okay? So don't get caught doing that. Be smart. Don't be hacking at the player, you know? Go like this, you know, play that. You know, get the deflections. That's more important, okay? So play smart. And you know what? Play physical. Play smart, but play physical. And what you want to do in that regard is, you know, the game of basketball is subjectively refs. Some refs will call it tight, some will call it loose. And what I mean by tight and loose is that, you know, when you're being physical and you're touching on them and you're poking on them, you're being physical, you know what? Some refs will let that go, okay? So you gotta feel out the refs. You have 5 fouls. Don't be afraid to kind of feel out the ref to find out, you know, is he gonna let me keep my hands in here? Or is he gonna say hands off, or is he gonna call that all the time? You know, can I play a little physical? Can I bump on him? You know, what is the ref going to do? How are they gonna call the game? Every ref is different, and every ref kind of picks and chooses their calls that way. So play physical, play smart, okay? P. E, be early, pick up early. You know, if you're wanna be a really great defensive player, if your guy does not, the guy that you're guarding, if he does not catch the ball, is he a threat offensively? Somewhat, but if he doesn't catch the ball, let's say he's the top scorer on the team, if you deny him the ball the whole game, okay, you pick him up early, guess what? You minimize his chances of scoring, okay? So pick up early. So that's E, be early, pick up early, be effective, okay? Be effective in what you're doing, okay? And so that's the E. For S, you wanna stay active. You always wanna be active, okay? You don't wanna have your hands down and take a break on defense. You can't take a break on defense. You can't just be here like this and not be active. So if you're a guarding the guy, you're active, you're bumping on him, okay? You're denying him the ball. You always want to be and stay active, okay? And stay strong, and let's remind ourselves, let's stay smart, okay? All right, so if you're, depending on the game and what the scoreboard is seeing and how many fouls there are we in the foul limit or whatever, you gotta stay smart, okay? So remind yourself to stay smart. And T in PEST, so we got P-E-E-S-T, T is tenacious, be aggressive, okay? If the player that you're guarding, he wants to go to the hoop, what do you wanna do? Make it hard for him. You know, don't chase your player around. Again, dictate where they go. So if this player, imagine a player here, he wants to cut this way, bump into him. No, you're not allowed there. Okay, make it difficult. Don't do this. He wants to go that way. Oh, you're going that? Okay, I'll go with you. All right, we want to be tenacious. We want to be aggressive. So P-E-S-T, P, play smart. E, pick up early, be effective, okay? S, stay active, stay strong, and remind yourself, stay smart, be smart. And T, go tenacious, be aggressive, all right? Be active there, all right? That is P-E-S-T. That's a great way to remind yourself on how to be a great defensive player. So I hope you get something out of this in regard to defense. And it really comes down to making a decision, committing to that decision, and doing the actions of P-E-S-T. And you'll be a great defensive player. And at the end of the day, remember, the game of basketball, though you're playing a lot around this guy here, but on the defensive end, you cannot take a break. Offensively, you can, but a coach will recognize if you're being lazy or you're not doing the P-E-S-T activities in defense, you're not gonna play a lot. So if you can be a great defensive player and, you know, a mediocre, average, above average offensive player, you will see a lot of court time. If you can stop their number one defender, their offensive player, their number two offensive player, their number three, if you're a great rebounder, you understand the rules and help side and helping your teammates be better defensively, you're gonna see yourself a lot of court time. So defense is huge, it's important, it's not taught enough, especially at the youth level. So I hope you guys get something out of this, and let's get better together.